Have you ever looked at Twitter's trending topics and felt confused? What if you could easily get context for those trends and know exactly what people are talking about? Well, I coded a website that gives context to Twitter trends, but how exactly did I make this website? The website first uses Twitter's API to retrieve trending topics and display them. When one of the trends are clicked, the website fetches the most popular and recent tweets associated with that trend. Then, we use OpenAI to analyze the tweets and provide context to the trend. However, there's an important step you need to do before using the website, which I will mention later. Now, a website is typically split into two major components, the backend and the frontend. The frontend is the part of the website that the users interact with and is used to display the data from the backend. The backend is the part of the website that is responsible for receiving requests from the frontend and sending responses back. Here, I am developing the backend with Express.js, which is needed in order for us to use Twitter's API and also create our own API to serve data to our frontend. Alright, so I've just developed the getting the trends function. So as you can see here, when we go to /trends/London, we can see that it actually outputs all the trends that are happening in London, all the Twitter trends. Next, I'm gonna develop the functionality to get the recent, oldest, and most popular trends based on the name of the trend. And yeah. Alright, so I've just finished developing the function where we can get the tweets based on the topic. So here we can see that we have a list of tweets objects, and each of the object has like different properties. And you can see here that they also have a text property, which is what we're going to use to extract and feed to our ChatGPT essentially. So I think I'm kind of done developing the backend. So now I need to develop the front end. I developed the front end of the website using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. This process mainly involved the design of the website and is usually my favorite part. Alright, so an update. We now have, like the basic layout of the website. Looks pretty decent, I guess. I don't know. What's important is that now we have the search functionality so we can actually get the trends at different locations. So if I type like London, for example, we can actually get the trends here. So now I need to just integrate the part where once you click on these trends, you get the summary. All right, cool. So there were actually like some errors, so it wasn't actually loading, but I fixed it and we have the context right here. So you can see that if we say, if we click on RIP Ron, then we can see that it takes some time and then it just generates it and says a sad day for Scottish football. Thoughts are with his family and friend. Rest in peace, Ron Gordon. A sad day for Scottish football. So we basically get an idea of what people are talking about. So I realized I wasn't actually using the right OpenAI model, and I realized this because the output wasn't exactly what I wanted. So in the next update, I actually used the correct model. Right, so now we can actually see, I did a little bit of modification because I didn't do it right the first time. So you can see that by clicking on one of it, we actually get the context to it, and it explains it based on the tweets that we feed it. This works really well, and I'm just now going to deploy it, and then I'll show you something like important that you need to know so that you can actually use the website at home. So once you reach the website, all you need to do is copy and paste in your API key in this section here, and then click on set. You'll get a notification, click OK. And then type in whatever location you want and click go. Then all the trends will pop up and you can click on any one of it to get the context right here. Thanks for watching and subscribe for more software engineering projects.